Contraption Review Time, Christmas Edition. By the way, I absolutely loved adding the Christmas lights to my Hoverbin ball up there. I might honestly keep them. Love them that much. Anyway, today we have a contraption that comes from the Nutcracker and the Four Realms, whereby I'd never seen it until this year and didn't know this contraption existed, so perfect chance to review it. Now, I will say this. Normally, I talk throughout the videos. However, this very first run-through, I'm going to let them explain because in a very rare instance, they actually explain parts of the contraption in the movie.
Okay, very still. This is how we'll do it. With science, mechanics, and a bit of luck.
Always that luck element.
First, we've got energy. The heat from the candle will make the balloon rise.
Elegant, a beautiful way to start a contraption.
With the momentum from the ball that hits the monkey and pivots onto the bellows, which blows the longboat, giving us Newton's third law of physics that says every action has an equal and opposite reaction. Yes!
Fantastic. Absolutely amazing. Couple things. One, certainly is a chain reaction machine, but what type of contraption is this? What type of chain reaction is it on our category list? Now, I also don't think that this is a real machine. I think that there was definitely CGI elements to it. So first up, I'm going to walk you through exactly the steps that happened because I didn't even understand it the very first time I watched it. I was a little confused. So the very simple task of this machine is to catch a mouse. Brilliant, very classic example. In this case, she lights a candle that heats the air that causes the balloon to rise, very much like a hot air balloon. And there's a counterweight on the other side. So basically, as that is able to lift the balloon, that then drops the counterweight. And that's what's kind of helping pull the balloon up on this. It's then, as the rising balloon goes up, it hits the spinner, knocking the ball sitting there on a pedestal, my little pedestal right there. Causing that to swing down. There's a little brush holding up the bellows. As that falls, the bellows is allowed to fall and push, pushing that long boat into those book dominoes, dropping the weight, which turns the spindle wheel, which raises that string. So it actually goes from a horizontal line into an inclined plane. And that's what allows that little monkey on a bicycle to roll down, causes that to fall, have that knife drop onto that whatever it is holding it, the string, and thus have the net come down and catch the mouse. Brilliant. Absolutely a chain reaction. Again, what type? Why don't I think it's a real contraption? Well, having done this for 30 years, I kind of have a good sense and feel as to what the physics is like. So in this very first instance, let's watch this candle as it rises. It's a very slow, gradual rise. And then all of a sudden in the next frame, just sudden, boom, it hits the next element and it is flying with so much force. And by the time that it actually hits, there is no slowdown in momentum right there. That doesn't feel natural to me, especially for just having lit that tiny little candle, just maybe a foot or two off from where it is. So I don't buy that that was real. That could either be someone pulling it or pushing it. As we get into the bellows, however, that's where I feel that there was certainly some embellishment and really a good chance of CGI. So, as the bellows fall, or as the element falls that allows the bellows to come down, I don't know if you've ever played with bellows before, but it's that act of pushing down, that's not so simple. That takes, you know, a good amount of effort. And even when you do, it doesn't generate that much wind. There's not that much power that comes from it. Now, as we watch this, it's able to push this longboat, this boat, a little bit, it's on wheels, but it's, again, it's on this little bit of an inclined plane. It's not that significant. It just shows that there's so much air pushing this thing. Also, when I build these contraptions, I test them over and over and over again. I mean, normally before an actual shoot, probably 50 times, genuinely. And let's watch as the bellow, as the bellows go, watch the boat. You can see there's all that dust surrounding the boat as it goes. There is this natural kind of like it sat there for quite a long time. That's again where I believe there's that CGI embellishment where this boat is traveling down in a way that is just, there seems like there's too much friction in the system. And finally, the real thing that gets me is this weight goes, which starts the spindle up. And that spindle has to, it's turning, which then turns another pulley gear system string. We don't know because we don't see it. And that's ending up pulling the string up into the air. Now, those monkey bites, they have a good amount of weight to them. So it has to raise that whole string up. I don't actually know what's causing this spindle to spin around, but that is quite a number of revolutions. That's not just a weight falling on one side, causing the wheel to maybe do a half quarter, three quarter revolution. It's continuously spinning 360, 720 degrees, something along that effect, in order to create something going from horizontal to maybe about a 15, 20, 30 degree angle. Again, I don't think the filming was that great in this machine. So in this case, if she's talking in the background, so basically the ball goes and we see the next element, we can buy that it's a more fluid machine. You know, it actually might be a reel, but there are those breakups to it. So it tells us that it might not have been a perfect run, or again, there very well might be that CGI embellishment, or, you know, the overall thing might have been done digitally. I'm not 100% sure. What I do know is that this machine, for certain, has a ton of everyday objects in it. Absolutely just filled with them because they're the stuff that's laying around their house. I mean, they're just kids trying to catch a mouse. A very simple everyday task. Maybe not that simple, but it is that very classic chain reaction, catch a mouse. From there, it's funny. It's humorous. It is a very unique contraption whereby, again, they have all their toy elements. It's got the dust blowing off, even if it is a CGI embellishment. The monkey rising, and again, trying to catch a mouse in the most creative way. That's just classically funny in a chain reaction. And of course, it is a chain reaction. One thing triggered the next. Absolutely. This is 100% a Rube Goldberg machine. Not only that, a Christmas Rube Goldberg machine. I'm so glad to have found one of these because I don't think I've definitely not reviewed one yet. I've certainly not seen one. I've made a couple myself, which I have those coming up very shortly. If I haven't released already, I don't know. I don't know my own schedule. But if you want to see those holiday movies, holiday Rube Goldberg machines that I built, certainly check them out in the links below. Certainly we'll put them at the end of this video. One of them actually destroys an office. Another one was built in a barn and it has gigantified objects. But for the case of the Nutcracker and the Four Realms, this machine can certainly be added to our Rube Goldberg classification. Well done. Phenomenal. I can't give it top marks only because, again, I'm not 100% sure that it wasn't altered in some way digitally, but nonetheless, fantastic contraption. And yeah, a little reminder that, hey, the fantastic contraption, Zach's Contraptions. Be sure to subscribe if you haven't already. If you have seen a Rube Goldberg machine that you think I've not seen before, certainly send it along. I'm happy to review it. And I hope to see you next time. Thank you so much for subscribing. And I want to give a very special shout out to Ariana Garcia, who happened to be my 1,000th subscriber. I know that doesn't sound like a lot, but guess what? Having done YouTube for quite a number of years and hit that milestone, I don't know. It was just one of those fantastic things. So Ariana Garcia, thank you so much for that. Thank you for everyone who has subscribed to the channel. I hope you do enjoy the content that this channel produces. Hoping to do a lot more, especially in the coming year, because we have some amazingly big things coming up. And in fact, as I record this video, I am getting ready to pack up and leave for a project involving Jägermeister. So be on the lookout for that. Again, I've been Zach Contraptions. Thank you so much. Happy holidays, and I'll see you next time.